Hello. Let's talk about how the European Union communicates to citizens. In this video, we will talk about the EU's communications to the public in the Eastern Partnership countries. Today, when fake news are being produced and spread through multiple platforms, including television and social media, what do citizens hear about the European Union? Do the EU's messages and policies reach citizens and affect their opinions and beliefs? Making sure citizens anywhere understand what the EU's policies are and what they do for them is a challenge. EU policies are numerous. Some are quite technical, while others affect people's lives indirectly. Providing accurate and accessible information about such policies is even more difficult in the EU's neighbourhood. For its neighbouring countries, the European Union has been a major trading partner, a source of assistance in trade, a beacon of economic development. But for some of them, it is much more than that. For example, Ukraine or Moldova have expressed aspirations to become members of the Union. For these states, the economic and political development of the European Union members from Central and Eastern Europe has been an attractive example to follow. The attractiveness of the EU model as a union of prosperous states that share certain democratic norms and principles has led some scholars to speak of the Union as a soft or normative power. The modernization drive, which the EU supports in closely associated countries, has earned it the label transformative power. When we look at the EU's Eastern Partnership, the overarching framework for relations with the Eastern neighbors, it also has a broad range of initiatives, platforms and tools. To disentangle who does what can be quite a challenge, even for specialists. Legal frameworks, for example, the association agreements shaping relations between the EU and Ukraine, Georgia and Moldova are quite complex. The trade provisions they establish, the so-called deep and comprehensive free trade agreements, are even more so. Such agreements have far-reaching effects on trade, business, public administration, infrastructure, and many more. These effects reveal themselves over time and may not be immediately visible for many citizens. Therefore, there are many reasons why it is difficult to communicate what the EU does to the broader public, to the citizens in the Eastern Partnership countries. Another problem is that the European Union's communications and policies towards the neighbourhood are increasingly undermined by various other actors, Russian troll factories, state TV channels, for example. These messages do not land in a neutral context anymore, but in a turbulent and unstable regional and global environment. This environment is characterized by mistrust in official sources, new ways of spreading falsehoods via social media, and some good old-fashioned propaganda. To investigate how the European Union's policies are understood in the region, we first researched how the EU communicates via official channels. Second, we analyzed what messages and news about the EU are disseminated via TV news in these countries. Third, we investigated how these messages are received by citizens. We also compared the EU's communications to that of other actors present in the region, especially Russia. Our findings show that the EU's recent strategy of differentiating its approach towards individual Eastern Partnership countries is reflected well in its official communications. However, the analysis of the style of communications presented in 2016 on the EU delegation's website suggested there was room for improvement. Fortunately, EU institutions have taken on board the need to develop and embrace more lively and personalized forms of communication. Examples are the Facebook campaigns in Moldova, the EU shows a red card to corruption, and the nationwide communication campaign launched in Ukraine more recently, Moving Forward Together. Despite the rising number of people getting their political news from the internet or social media, television remains a major source of political information for citizens in the Eastern neighborhood countries. Our experts watched and coded local evening news broadcasts in Belarus, Moldova and Ukraine for 4 months in 2017. Our analysis of these broadcasts showed that most of the news items about the EU, member states, Russia, and Eurasian Economic Union were neutral. They had no explicit evaluative tone or were balanced in that they presented different sides of the same story. In 377 hours of monitored material, we did not encounter fake stories about the EU. Our overview, however, excluded the Russian TV channels, which at the time were freely available in Moldova and Belarus, and continue also today to actively target citizens in these countries. What did the national news channels talk about when mentioning the EU? It differed per country. In Belarus, Russia received much more coverage in economic news than the European Union did. The EU was mentioned when reporting international developments or news linked to certain values. However, in contrast to EU communications spread via the delegation websites, the EU did not appear on Belarusian TV as mostly dealing with human rights promotion. Rather, EU was presented as an actor struggling with the challenges of multiculturalism and even terrorism. While the EU got covered in equal measure by items that had balanced positive and negative tone, Russia received mostly positive coverage in Belarus. In Moldova, by contrast, the EU and its member states were mentioned most frequently in economic news. In Ukraine, the EU was most often mentioned in news items discussing security and the visa-free regime between Ukraine and the Union, an important topic for citizens. This balanced tone on national news is good news, if we do not consider Russian TV channels. However, TV news and EU delegation websites are by far not the only ways in which people learn about the European Union or Russia. Local actors, ambassadors, church leaders, veterans, or civil society organizations promote and spread messages and discourses about the EU or Russia and serve as another important channel of communication. You can find more about these actors and how they act on the website of the EU-STRAT project.